This was fun.
Wait, we haven't even had sex again yet.
I'm just not that kind of girl. I only have sex once on the first date. I'm just gonna call an Uber.
Your driver will be ready as soon as he puts on his pants. Is your bed
made? Watch and learn, bye.
Oh, crush.
I have to tell you something, bye. I've been dating this girl. She's white.
A white girl?
Hey, you can't look like you and yell white girl.
It's okay. We hate terrorists.
I wonder who that could be.
I'm guessing it's a young, single Pakistani woman.
This is Zubeda.
For your files? Your X-Files? That's your favorite show, huh?
The truth is out there.
You know, your character, he's... And in real life, you were supposed to have an arranged marriage. What was it about Emily that made you want to kind of risk being with her?
You know what it was? When I would always date women, I would think in the future, mm-hmm. when I'm like, oh, the new Jurassic Park's coming out, I wouldn't imagine that they would be there watching it with me. But with Emily, I would be like, I remember like, Pan's Labyrinth, that's going to come out. I can't wait to see that with Emily. And I was like, oh, that's weird. In the past, the assumption was that my girlfriend wouldn't be there, but now the assumption was that she would be there. So there were all these like subtle things, but ultimately, I mean, I just love her.
I like that. That's actually, I think as a critic, I think that's a big compliment to tell someone's like, you're the person I want to see this movie with me.
Yeah, I know. It's a special thing. I remember when I saw the trailer for Pan's Labyrinth, I was like, oh, that movie's going to be great. I can't wait to bring Emily to see it with me.
So sweet.
Are you judging Pakistan's next top model?
You know how we have arranged marriage in my culture?
Oh my God, I'm so stupid. Can you imagine a world in which we end up together?
I don't know.
I'm looking for Emily Gardner. She was checked in tonight.
There's an infection. We put her in a medically induced coma.
Coma.
You should call her family.
Thank you, Kamala. We're gonna handle things from here.
I think I'm just gonna wait anyway.
You guys broke up. I'm not sure why you're here.
I'm just gonna stay for a second. Is this seat? Okay. Is that lady still looking at me?
I have to ask, because I know this happened in the movie too. Do you actually like watch her sometimes when you're making her watch a movie that you like?
Yeah, well, now we all have the same movies that we love. But yeah, when I show her movies, I'm like, you know that feeling when you're like showing someone something that you really love?
Yeah.
And you're like, God, I hope they love it. God, I hope it holds up. Because sometimes, you know, you're younger, you watch something and you love it. And each time you're watching it, you're like connecting to that experience, that memory.
Yeah.
And then sometimes it happens both ways. She'll show me something and I'm like, that's okay. And she's like, I guess I was at the right time. And same thing the other way around. You know, I'll show her something and she's like, okay, I guess your brain was smaller when you liked that.
Yeah. No, I do the same thing. I have to control myself. I've been told to stop because I can't help but like, if there's a part in a movie you want to, and you're like, watch this part. It's so good.
I find, you know what scene I always show people a lot, not like necessarily dates, is the first monster attack in The Host. Have you seen The Host?
No.
It's a Korean monster movie. Okay. And there's a monster attack that happens. And this is why it's good, because a lot of people haven't seen it. There's a monster attack that happens in it like in daylight, like at like noon, and it's just this monster running around. You usually see monsters at night. This is like a daytime attack. It's attacking like this really public area, and it's one of the best scenes in any movie. And when I show that to people, I'm like, what? So good. And it's a great monster.
Yeah.
So 9/11, I've always wanted to have a conversation with people.
You've never talked to people about 9/11? I'm still standing.
I'm still standing. Want to do anything? You got any Paula games?
No, I haven't.
You ever play it? You can't rhyme it? You try to find a word that nobody can rhyme.
Okay. And Stonehenge.
What has it been like for you to not only have y'all's story on the big screen, but also get all this positive like reaction that you guys have been getting?
It's very gratifying, because if people didn't like it, that it would be hard not to take that personally. But also, you know, whenever you make something and put it out there, it's pretty personal. Even if it's not your story, you've invested in it, you spend time on it, presumably you really believe in it. So it's always very personal. And it's this weird mix, because you sort of want to be like, I don't care what other people think. I made it, I want to like it, and I do. But then it's hard when it comes out, you're like, well, no, I kind of want everyone to like it, you know? Yeah. So it's, but it's been great. And what's really lovely is people who really connect to it because of their experiences in very specific ways, or people who notice like little stuff that we had talked about that they were like, I really like that moment, you yeah. know? Well, I really love that. And I also love just people finding like, finding meaning in it. If you go,
then go with me. I think I screwed up with your daughter.
Yeah, you did. Won't you
take me? Let me give you some advice, Kamal. Love isn't easy. That's why they call it love.
I don't really get that.
I know. I thought I could just start saying something and something smart would come out.